Hey everyone, so welcome back to another video. So those of you who like stock Android and Pixel devices, the ROM that I'm going to review today is one of the best and polished ROM out there, be it in terms of performance or features. So this ROM is called Descendant X. Well, the name surely is a bit hard to speak. So in this video, let's have an in-depth look at the Descendant X ROM for Oneplus 6 and other devices. And before we begin, make sure you hit that subscribe button and press the bell icon next to it to stay notified about the latest videos. It's free and helps the channel out. So if you need instructions to flash this ROM, you will get them at the end of this video. So stay tuned till the end to know more about it. Well, after completing the whole setup, you can see the clean looking stock UI in all its glory. The default launcher is Launcher, and it brings a lot of customization in this ROM, including support for custom icon packs, gestures, and a lot more. Now coming to the notification panel. Well, this one is a bit different. As you can see, you cannot scroll it down completely, as the length of notification shade is also a bit less than what you generally see in other ROMs. And you also get this brightness slider, which comes in handy sometimes. And what I really like about this ROM are the volume controls. So this animation looks great, and it's handy than what you get on stock Android. Plus, it also displays the volume of Bluetooth device connected. But in this version, it's a bit off-centered. But I hope it will get fixed in the future updates, as it is a minor issue. Now let's jump into the settings and check what new features we have in this ROM. So we do have Wi-Fi calling, and you will have to turn it on in the network settings, and it works just fine. In display settings, you do have a lot of new things. Apart from usual brightness and color controls, this one supports always on display with music ticker. And you can modify it a bit with the clock flow settings and more, and make your ambient display even more fancy. The main new feature here is Thumb UI. Well, this is suited for those who like to use their device with one hand. And this will shift everything down so that you can access every corner of the device single-handedly. And it works like a charm. And it even tweaks your notification panel with much required features, which just looks and feels great to use. And face unlock lovers, this has face unlock built right into the ROM itself, and you can control it the way you want to. So thumbs up for it. Plus, while we are at it, it has more things from OxygenOS, like DC dimming, panel modes, alert slider customization, and three finger screenshots. Though, long screenshots are not there as of now. And as usual, you can customize these gestures and even hide this bottom bar. Plus the usual features like live captions, screen recorder, digital well-being, along with Gcam support are present in this ROM. And it even has OxygenOS gallery and camera app as default, which is just great. One small thing I would like to point out is the power menu that feels new and refreshed and has all the advanced options enabled by default. Now coming to the battery life. So the battery life I got on this ROM was around 5 hours on a single charge, with a couple of PUBG sessions of around half an hour each. And it did heat up less than OxygenOS, which is impressive, as I was able to play a half an hour long session without any issues. Well, that too on extreme settings. But the overall standby drain was on the higher side, especially if you keep the Wi-Fi on all the time. And overall, I'm impressed by this ROM, and I think it will improve a lot in future and might be among the best ROMs out there. So now the instructions on how to flash this ROM. So first of all, remove all the lock screen passwords and reboot your device to twrp recovery. Now flash the latest OxygenOS 10.zip file. So simply click on install and choose the OxygenOS 10.zip file. So swipe to confirm flash. So after it gets complete, flash the latest twrp.zip file. Now reboot your device to recovery mode once again. Now click on install and flash the latest OxygenOS 10.zip file once again. After that, flash the latest twrp.zip file, as you did in the first step. And now reboot your device to the recovery mode. So now it's time to flash the ROM itself. Now click on install and choose the zip file of the ROM. Now let it install, and after it's done, click on reboot and reboot to system. So that's it. So like this video if it helps you out, and feel free to ask any questions if you have in the comment section down below. And I'll see you guys in the next one.